Now we are quite well prepared to start the build process. Simply type make in the coreboot's redirectory and observe how the files are compiled. You will surely notice the pattern of the compiled files. There are many files from generic coreboot directories like lib and board specific directories like mainboard emulation QEMU Q35 and sawbridge intel and the model. You will also probably notice that each line starts with the name of the stage it is compiled for. In case of the below output, it is boot block. Later the message will contain ROM stage, postcard, ROM stage, as well as messages about cloning and building CBIOS payload. So let's go through the process since the beginning. I will configure once again the mainboard, which is the Q35, save the configuration file and type make. It starts with some submodules and other utilities and then proceeds with bootlock and the ROM stage and ROM stage. As you can see, many lib entries are here. Drivers, device, and now the SMM module and other ROM stage sources. It's not in the right order because before the ROM stage begins, the postcard is executed. So the postcard stage is compiled after ROM stage right now. And then we have cloning of the CBIOS payload and it is being compiled. And now after all parts are ready, the CBFS tool is compiled. It is compiled with the host toolchain, which is indicated by host CC. And then we have some vBoot utilities. And now whole image is packed, and as indicated by the CBFS. I will explain the CBFS and the soon lessons. So now the build for the QEMU Q35 is ready. So at the end of the build process, the build system prints the contents of the coreboot image, the CBFS contents. Here you may see that the stages have been put inside the image. Depending on the configuration and payload, there may be other files like VGA option ROMs, secondary payloads, or configuration files like coreboot for boot order for CBIOS. Bootblock will always be at the bottom of CBFS for x86 architecture. Because of the recent vector being on the top of the 4 GB of physical memory, the boot firmware is always mapped at the top of 4 GB memory minus the SPI flash size. So, but what really is CBFS? We can see some file names, offsets, types, sizes, and compression, maybe compression. I will explain that in the next lesson.